My name is Juan Carrique-Mas. I am based at Oxford University Clinical Research Unit in Ho Chi Minh City in Vietnam. I am currently funded by the Wellcome Trust to carry out a large-scale field intervention to help farmers in the Mekong Delta of Vietnam to reduce their reliance on antimicrobials to produce chickens. Antimicrobial use and antimicrobial resistance is a considerable problem in animal production, not only in human medicine, and this has been realized only very recently. It is a bit of a problem because farmers use a lot of large amounts of antimicrobials to raise the chicks and the chickens because they basically have no technical support from the veterinary system. And also it is a problem because most of these small-scale farms have virtually no biosecurity, that is almost no separation between the farming space and the household space. So that means there's a lot of exposure in these communities to the animals they are raising. It's been estimated that approximately half of the population across the country would raise some form of food animal. That can be from a few chickens to several hundreds of chickens, pigs, ducks, etc. Overall, in terms of households, the census speaks about between 8 and 10 million animal-raising households. Antimicrobial resistance is indeed what we call these days a one health issue. That is not, we cannot just look at humans or animals or the environment. Everything is interconnected. In the case of antimicrobial use in animal production, it is quite clear that there can be transmission of bacteria, resistant bacteria, which are pathogenic to the humans, causing disease in those humans in contact, but also indirectly through the consumption of food from these animals, contaminated meat, milk, eggs, and so on. And furthermore, those resistant bacteria can spread into the environment and contaminate the water streams, rivers, crops, and end up in our food as well, even though we are not directly raising those animals. Right, the ViParc project stands for Vietnamese Platform for Antimicrobial Reductions in Chicken Production. I also tell people that the VI stands for a veterinary intervention, because what it really is a trial which we are trialing an intervention system to help farmers reduce their levels of antimicrobials in raising their chickens. So it is very much focused on small-scale production systems, so we are not looking at the industrial integrated farms, which are still relatively few, but on the medium and small-scale farmer. So what we are really doing here is very much like a clinical trial in human medicine, where we have an observation phase, and then we randomly allocate to two interventions and one control. One novelty of the ViParc project compared to other research projects is that we have included a strong socioeconomic component, because we realize that farms are businesses. So if we don't really consider them to be, you know, running their own business, we just look at it from a health perspective only, we will not be able to have an impact on them. What is really challenging about the Vietnamese and the Mekong Delta situation is that farms are much more complex than we envisage. Every farmer does things in slightly different ways, and that presents problems, because that also means that we cannot design an intervention that fits all. That's why the intervention has to be tailor-made. Every farmer will really be approached and will be advised on the specific problems on their farms. I believe the type of research that I am currently conducting, which is an intervention trial, is very relevant and very necessary. There's a lack of intervention studies that look at the important issue of antimicrobial use and resistance in animal production. Most of the studies are observational, and very few of them attempt to really do something at a large scale. But I also feel that my study, my intervention, is quite representative of other production systems and even other countries we conduct similar type of farming than Vietnam.